Before you go, Elder, I might need your assistance on this one here. Now, you know how we over and over and over try and instruct these people. Now, we ain't getting a nickel out of this thing. Ain't nobody here on no payroll.
Nah.
But we continue to try and inform y'all about these wicked men, right? Mm-hmm. Who y'all listening to? And now that the man done went and let the old, he done opened up the vault to let you know what's what, right? You gonna start to see these men try even harder to take advantage of these people, right? Mm-hmm. And we came across something that's rather disturbing, right? And I'm just going to share it with y'all, right? Can y'all see that thing right there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, do y'all understand what this is?
Robbery.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
You want them to donate land?
No,
we don't have the full understanding of whether they talking about giving up their own.
No, they want money.
They want money.
They asking for money.
Because they mentioned PayPal in the deal right here. Y'all see that?
Mm-hmm.
I see.
Now we've been telling y'all these men ain't nothing but damnable liars and thieves and thugs. The Most High calls them brutish.
Mm-hmm. All right. Most I call him Satan himself. He call him Satan.
All right. Now, I would like the elder to go over a couple of things, because this is my first question in a situation like this here. Right. Now, the Most High say he gonna give you the land. Right.
Yes.
He said he gonna take the land. Now, we don't believe in the land that they talking about. We know it's talking about his doctrine, right?
Yes.
But all y'all believe in this kind of foolishness that he talking about, that land over there, that desert that ain't producing nothing and about to go on because they done shut off the Red Sea. That place, they can't grow nothing over there. They getting everything shipped in over there.
Yeah.
All right. If it's such a fertile land, why they got to ship everything in over there? All right. But if the Most High, according to your doctrine, say that y'all going to take the kingdom.
Yes.
Why, pray tell, do y'all need to get money to buy land?
Mm-hmm. Go to Isaiah 52 and 3.
I figured you probably want to go ahead and
Yes, because is the Most High, does the Most High dwell? What do he dwell? In you. In you. He do not dwell. He dwells in a land because you dwell in a land.
See, I said what?
Under 52, I think it's 3. It's 2 and 3. And we know what's going on. They're grabbing at everything. They're grabbing at everything. You know, they're crabs right now. They're grabbing at everything.
Yeah, because they're devils and they're selling something, and they want those people to buy whatever it is they're selling.
Yes. So gird up your loins, because you and the viewers that's been watching us, you've been taken out of Egypt. So you're going to have to dwell in a place in your mind at a higher standard. That's what Zion do. Zion are people that's the elders who look at things and they weigh the fire of everything. They are the adults that the Most High dealing with. But if you can, Elder, who read? Elder Jariah?
Can you read for us today, Jariah?
And I want to give a shout out to LCK. God of Israel, Bucket Backer, what's his name, Elder?
Bucket.
Buckling, yeah, brother. I mean, New Wine,
Yes.
These people have been with us a good little while, and I really want to give a special shout out to LCK, because them brothers been working hard over there. We slightly have different doctrines, but one doctrine we do have, we love one another.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We love one another. And they've been working hard, because this thing is at the head now. It's about to, it's about to be a mighty earthquake soon, because we're going to go through past what Passover is about, what the Most High was talking about. But if you can, Elder Dwight, please read that.
Yes, sir. Isaiah chapter 52 and verse 3. For thus saith the Lord, ye have sold yourselves for naught, and ye shall be redeemed without money.
Oops. Well, you don't need no money. You don't need no money. You don't need no money. We see the thing is, me and Elder Stephan did a class, Purple Thorns, a while back. And we was going over, what that was at, Mark 4?
Yes.
The Most High, let's go to Mark 4 for a second. Because this right here, the land he's talking about, the Most High land, what he's talking about is a level of understanding.
Yes.
Zechariah 12 and 6. It's called Jerusalem. Your Jerusalem, the carnal people fighting over that. He said, my Jerusalem is in this doctrine. See, that's what he's talking about for salvation. But we're going to say it about that one. Yeah, that's it right here.
One of the first one?
Or wait, yes, sir.
You start that?
That's good right there, Elder.
Okay.
Mark chapter 4 and verse 1. And he began again to teach by the seaside.
Now.
And there was gathered.
Hold tight, Elder. When you see sea, that's water.
Mm-hmm.
Carnally, you were thinking that he's standing by the sea.
Mm-hmm.
But spiritually, he's talking about doctrines. So stop
side,
right there.
That's what side mean too. Side mean doctrine.
You see that?
When the Most High say beat your child on his side, he ain't talking about beating your child, abusing your child and all that other stuff. He talking about correcting the doctrine of somebody following you, one of your students. Side means side means doctrine. It's at the bottom of the screen. Go where?
Go Psalm 18 and 6. Psalm 18 and 6. Where? 16. Many waters. Many waters go to the sea, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's talking about. Most Christ dealing with doctrines. Most High dealing with doctrines. That's all they doing is dealing with the doctrines.
Right.
You got never gain through doctrines to get to the right path to Jerusalem, the righteous, the everlasting doctrine.
18, what?
16, I think it's 16. Many waters.
Yep.
Yeah.
Psalms chapter 18 and verse 16. He sent from above. He took me. He drew me out of many waters.
See that?
Water is doctrine.
Doctor, go to 4. Chapter 4. 18 and 4.
Verse 4. The sorrows of death compassed me, and the floods of ungodly men made me afraid.
These men got doctrines in them, the Most High calling them wars. Y'all see that?
Yes.
That's what King David is talking about. He was drawn away from that mess. You see what I'm saying? Teaching those other doctrines. He was drawn out of that. He gave him the right path to what he's supposed to be, the right path that he's supposed to be on. So we go back to...
just to show them that the water is talking about doctrines. Read that out.
Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 26. That he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of the water by the word.
The word is, when he's using the word water in the scriptures, he's talking about the word of God. All right?
Mm-hmm.
Flood, seas, rivers.
Rain.
Yes.
Rain.
Any type of thing where they start talking about what, even versions of what, hell, snow, all that stuff talking about doctrine. All right.
Doctrine.
That's the word. There's the word that the Most High has, and then there's the word that these carnal preachers and prophets have. All right. So
show them where it's at, Elder. 1 Thessalonians 2:13. I think it's 2:13. His word is totally different from carnal. I think it's 2:13. His word is totally different. Yes.
1 Thessalonians 2:13. For this cause also thank we God without ceasing, because when ye received the word of God which ye heard of us, ye received it not as...
Oh, hold tight.
See, so the word of God is totally different from man. It's totally different. You receive the word of God. Just reading the Bible, we're going to touch on what it's talking about, Joshua 1:8, if we got time. Mm-hmm. When it's talking about meditate therein, mm-hmm. He's not talking about touching the surface of the Bible. You got to get the spiritual interpretation there in the Bible, what it's actually saying.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Novel, carnal, and spiritual is what he wants. That's the meat. We're going to touch on these things. Read.
You received it not as the word of men, but as it is in truth, the word of God, which effectually worketh also in you that believe.
Man is carnal. Ecclesiastes 3:18. He's still fighting that carnal man inside himself, the beast. You probably need to go back to it, Elder. Go to Ecclesiastes 3:18. Yeah, Ecclesiastes 3:18. Because you still find that old person in you. Romans 6:6. You got to destroy the old man, that old person in you, and do what God said, which is the spiritual interpretation. And he's going to wake them up very soon. And we're bringing it through the scripture. They're going to get this. He's going to break them. That man, the thing of IUIC, going to run them down. He's going to run them to death. He's going to run them to death. And I see his future. I see his future out of the Bible. What the Most High gonna do to him and the men that follow him and the women that follow him? I see it. Even his doctrine. He said it's not even gonna be known in the streets nowhere. He's tired of it. We'll get out of scripture. Don't believe what I say. It's Most High is terrified. He's terrified because when you read the Bible, it seems so peaceful when you read it. Yeah. But he actually, in my head, he's shouting at me.
Yeah,
he said, eat this bread with quaking. Yeah. And he mean what he say. They take it for granted. They take the low way, that's carnal interpretation. He's on the highway, the spiritual interpretation. Mm-hmm. So since we've been drawn out of these doctrines, we understand that we have to show the Most High every day with respect. He only want the meat. That's all he want now, the meat. He don't want that carnal mess. When Christ showed up, like I say, with John, when John saw him, he said, oh, time's up. I got to be baptized for you. He knew the deal. We get out of scripture. You know that's a law inside the Bible, because that's what I studied, the law. And I've been waiting for this a long time. But read that.
Ecclesiastes 3:18. I said in mine heart concerning the estate of the sons of men, that God might manifest them, and that they might see that they themselves are beasts.
See that? Sons of men. Sons of men. Because that's not sons of God. They're sons of men. They follow the carnal interpretation. Yeah. So what was that? Yeah.
Okay. Just to back up what you saying.
Mm-hmm.
You see it again. Right here. It's a difference. He got a different speech than men. All right. The Most High's doctrine is different than all of this stuff that these people teaching. We're not saying we know all of it, but we know how to take two or three precepts and get the understanding. This is the second precept showing you the Most High, he speak different than man speak. Read that, Elder.
1 Corinthians 2:4. And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom.
See, he's saying he's making a distinction between man's wisdom. Read.
But in demonstration of the spirit and of power.
That's a different speech. That's a different language. Okay, the Most High speaks a different language than men speak. That's like Elder Samuel brought in that precept before. Read.
Verse 5. That your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men.
You can't depend on a man to give you any understanding. All right. That's why people, they following these guys like the IUIC crowd and all these Israelite pastors. They following these different Christian pastors or whatever religion that they're following, and they're taking a man's understanding. Where you see us, we keep using two or three precepts because that's God's language. The language of man ain't gonna profit nobody. Read.
Right. But in the power of God.
That's the power we teach. Power means doctrine. You can see it at the bottom of the screen. Power means doctrine. All right. We preach the power of God, the doctrine of God. Read.
Verse 6. Howbeit, we speak wisdom among them that are perfect.
Y'all see that? That's the speech that we have.
Yes.
All right. Read.
Yet not the wisdom of this world, nor of the princes of this world that come to naught.
They've been teaching that thing about black men is the Israelites for all this long time, you know. But that's the wisdom of the world. Just because a black person happened to fit the description of the Bible don't mean only black people gonna get the kingdom. That's a doctrine or an agenda of a man. But the doctrine, he's sitting up there saying, you mean to tell me all this powerful doctrine I got? You telling me all I can draw is black people? He said, man, I can draw the whole world. How you gonna live in the power of my doctrine? Get up in there. He make an assumption. Well, we got it from here, Mosiah. You can go ahead and sit down over there in the corner. We'll take it from here. Their agenda different than his agenda.
Total different. Total different speech.
Verse 7. But we speak the wisdom of God in a mystery.
A parable. Allegory. Okay?
Yes.
It's a mystery. It's a metaphor.
Mark 4 and 2, Matthew 13, chapter 13, verse 10, 11, Deuteronomy chapter 32, and verse 2. Again. Yes.
Read.
Even the hidden wisdom which God ordained before the world unto our glory.
Before he made the world, he made this doctrine here.
Yes.
This doctrine that he got. But he only gave it to certain people. That's the speech we use.
Yes.
Now look what he say about these men, right? Read.
Verse 8. Which none of the princes of this world knew.
He telling these people who teaching all of these churches and all of these synagogues and all of these different organizations that's teaching, they don't know his doctrine. They don't know it.
They don't know it. At a time, and I want to intervene with something. At a time a man come in and tell you how to run your household, he covet thy household because he's a prince of this world. Yes. Only thing he's supposed to do, he says, seek the kingdom first. Teach my doctrine first. But what did they do? They start teaching carnal things to you and they take over your household.
Yes.
Yeah. His speech is totally different. And nobody want to teach his doctrine but elders of Israel and some of the viewers that's watching us. And it's here and there, brothers are teaching. They saying what they are teaching. But we're going to go. You finish, Elder. Go ahead, Elder.
We're just going to finish this on out. and then we're gonna go okay. back to so that you can show them, because mm-hmm. right now them people, they working, they know the jig is up, as they say.
Oh, they know.
Yes.
So they know it. What they doing? They going full time to get that money out y'all pocket. And the only reason we doing this is because of lambs. All right, a lamb. He's so innocent. He'll stand in line patient.
Yes.
Waiting to be slaughtered. That's what y'all is. Some of y'all get yes. exactly what y'all deserve. But it's some lambs over there. And the Most High say we got to have compassion for these lambs. We got to leave mm-hmm. the whole other flock to find that one lamb. All right? Mm-hmm. It's one lamb here or there. Okay? In these camps. And they in there giving these people their money. And these people exclusively eat lamb. That's all they eat. They don't even eat vegetables. All they eat is lamb. All right?
Yes.
And y'all getting slaughtered. But a lamb will sit patiently in line while he hear his brother down the line over in there getting carved up.
Yeah.
But he'll just patiently wait to be slaughtered too. That's the only reason we doing that, trying to save some of y'all.
Yes.
All right.
And we will. We will.
Finish this out, Elder.
For had they known it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory.
So they crucify the Lord, which is the doctrine, every time they come with that foolishness that they teaching, causing these people to believe these lies so that they can get their money. Because eventually they're going to start running up out of here. They're going to be getting up out of here. They right now, they're trying to get what money that they came.
That's it.
From these people. And then they're going to disappear. Right? You can see it. The writing on the wall. They know now. Like, soon the people found out that they was following the Superman Jesus doctrine, them people started looking kind of sideways.
Yes.
What did he say? Yeah, you start looking like a fool, then you start asking yourself, wait a minute, what am I doing? Yeah, he knows.
Right.
He knows that thing made him look bad. Because people finally took that veil off, and you could see he ain't nothing but Slewfoot, the devil. Yes.
The devil. And we go to 1 Corinthians 2:12. We done with this about money. We're gonna break this down by freely.
I want to add something before
you go. Sir.
Oh, go ahead, Tobias.
Romans 1:16-17.
Romans 1:16?
Yes.
17. Read that
up. Romans 1:16. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth.
Did Christ speak another? He spoke in parables.
Yes.
He taught in parables. His definition of words was totally different from the carnal man who he was talking to, wasn't it?
Yes.
We're not ashamed to talk like that.
Right.
That's the salvation of the power of God, a salvation to everyone that believe it.
Yes.
That's the salvation doctrine, right?
That's it.
I don't know why people say they love Jesus, but they don't even know his speech.
Yes.
We're going to prove it today. We're going to prove it today. Oh, read on, Elder.
To the Jew first, and also to the Greek.
Now, the Jew is Romans 2:29.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's the Jew he's talking about. So the rest of the Jews can help that brother
mm-hmm.
kill that old person in him.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all see that?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Mm-hmm. To the Jew first.
Also with this Greek. Because the first thing they do, right? Now, you don't see it here, right? So if you don't see it here, if you're not careful, a man can come and he can go and get a book. Like the Zondervan Bible Dictionary, right? And he can take you on a path to show you that the Greek is the Hellenized Jew. To make you think that he's talking about two different types of Greeks, right? But the problem that they got is it ain't there. So that you just gonna have to trust him that that's what that means. But you can't say that the Greek in this scripture is talking about the Hellenized Jews. But whenever you go over there to, what is it, Joel 3? Mm-hmm. And they start talking about that they gave the Israelites to the Grecians.
Oh, yeah, Joel 3. Yeah.
You can't have it both ways, mm-hmm. All right? Either the Greek is the white man, as you say, or he's a Hellenized Jew. Mm-hmm. So if that's the case, and Joel is saying that the people gave the Israelites to Hellenized Jews, you can't have it both ways.
You can't. No. They were sucking into those doctrines.
Yeah.
Greek mythology. Yeah. All kind of other things. Those doctrines. Most are dealing with doctrines. He dealing with doctrines. I mean, and they got suckered into those doctrines that they had.
Yeah.
That's why he throw down Esau house. He's gonna throw it down. He threw down Israel house many times. It's in the Bible. Look it up. He threw them down many times till you get the right doctrine. He watching you with watching other word. Like Elder Stevens said, they know what time it is.
Yes.
They know that doctrine is whack. It's whack. We have destroyed that doctrine. I mean, we're gonna destroy Passover today.
Yes.
We're gonna destroy Passover today. What that Passover? Passover is still going on. But we're gonna destroy that today out of the Bible.
Yes. But read on, Elder.
Mm-hmm. Romans chapter 1 and verse 17. Okay. For therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith. Mm-hmm. As it is written, the just shall live by faith.
He telling you the just people are going to be the ones that live by the spiritual doctrine. Faith is the spiritual doctrine. All right.
Yes.
That's what he's telling you. All that carnal foolishness ain't going to amount to a hill of beans. Yeah, you know now that the Israelites are the black people, but how you get salvation?
How you get salvation?
They don't know how to give it to you because they carnal. He's sitting there telling you.
Yes.
Only faith going to get you the king. They don't know the doctrine of faith.
Yes, you got to believe this doctrine.
They're going to kill a bunch of white folks and all of the other nations going to be in handcuffs and all that other stuff. All right, but how you get salvation? They don't know.
They're pitiful. They're pitiful, man. They pitiful. But,
you said 1 Corinthians 2 and 12.
Yeah, go to 12. Because you spoke about... they're talking about giving donation for land, right? Lord have mercy. Could you imagine them, they having a country and they the polices of the land? Brother, they'll be murdering everybody.
Yes.
Could you imagine that?
That's right.
This man talking about killing his wife when he died.
Yes.
We got him on recording.
Yes.
He said burn her up.
Yes.
Burn everything up. Could you imagine that?
Yes.
We got him on record. He said, burn his wife up. I guess that means murdering his wife.
Yeah.
And Kalai said, oh, no, I ain't going to do that. He said, I'm for real.
Yes.
He just joking, trying to play. He said, I'm for real.
That's right.
He's talking about burning up his wife.
That's right. That's that video of you can't please the devil.
Yes.
That's the one.
Yes.
Go ahead, Elder.
1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 12. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of God, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of God.
Did he say free?
Mm-hmm. Freely.
832. Mm-hmm. He's saying freely, right? Why are you giving your money?
Yes.
What, you trying to buy heaven? Yes. Now you went to IUIC to get salvation, to learn how to get salvation. Now we're gonna go back to Mark 4 because he don't lure you into the world.
Yes.
Y'all see that?
Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to come out of the world, meaning the carnal interpretation, and go into spiritual interpretation. Christ came into the world to get you out of that carnal interpretation and bring you into the spiritual understanding. That's why he said that he went into hell, he went into those camps.
And that is your Passover.
Yeah.
Straight up. Mm-hmm. He went. What's the elder Tobiah?
Mm-hmm. Like I said, that is your Passover.
Yes. That's your Passover. That's your Passover.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Read, go ahead, read that up.
Romans chapter 8, verse 32. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him.
The Most High.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
But delivered him up for us all. How shall he elevated. Not?
He taught him at an elevated level. That's what they're talking about, delivered up. So we're supposed to go to a higher level understanding what he's talking about.
From his this example. Doctrine. That's the this example.
Yes.
How shall he not with him also freely give us all things?
All things. Well, I'm about to be buying some land for. He said I'm gonna give it to you.
Right.
If carnally.
Ain't that crazy?
Say all things. Right. Give us all things.
Man.
What are you talking about? I want everlasting life to be with my with the Most High. I want to be with the Most High. Say, I'm sorry, Pops. I'm sorry. I was a clown for a little while. I'm sorry. Please forgive me.
I figured it out now.
Yeah, I figured it out. I only got one God. Acts 26, 26. Then we go back to Mark 4 to clear that up. I think it's 26, 26. Let's see. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Acts chapter 26 and verse 26. For the king knoweth of these things, before whom also I speak. Freely.
Freely, 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 freely. Mm-hmm.
For I am persuaded that none of these things are hidden from him.
Stop. The reason why? Because the Ecclesiastes 7 and 7, it destroys you. A gift destroys the heart. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's why we speak freely over here. We tell them this. Hey, I want my money back. Okay. Zero. That's what you get. Zero. That's what you gave me. Zero. You see that? We're tied down. Nobody paying. Nobody paying my bills but the Most High. So I go to hell. You see that? I ain't looking for no extra paycheck. Nathaniel, shut up. Get in that building. See that? Get off that street. Get off that street, harlot. Nobody paying me. You see what I'm saying? The Most High paying us.
Yes.
We could say we a gift destroyed the heart.
Right.
We ain't got to do that. See what the bishop say. No. Get away from me. God is on my head.
Right.
This doctrine and the Most High, he's on my head. Yes. I'm possessed by him. I've been consumed by him.
Yes.
He's my master. He's my teacher. He's my all. Of course, I love my brothers and sisters.
Yes.
But I keep him first.
Mm-hmm.
I keep him first all the time. That's just the way it is.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
For I am persuaded that none of these things are hidden from him. For this thing was not done in a corner.
See that? Nobody caught pull me in, O'Connell. Say, Sam, you can't say that.
Right. Right.
No, and your yes boy. I'm not your yes boy. You ain't putting me in, O'Connell. Bishop Nathaniel. You the devil.
Yes.
You the devil.
when he made that 501c3. That man was already counting the checks before when he made that. You see what I'm saying? That man established IUIC 20 something years ago, set that 501c3 up because he knew he finna have a cash flow generator. That's what that is.
Yes.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying? This man been buying. This man been in collecting money for 20 years.
Yes.
How you don't got no land yet?
Yeah.
You done retired yourself. You retired Laba. You retired a lot of them, and you pay their salary out of Passover, all that money that's collected, they divvy that up. They pay for their kids with y'all kids' money.
Yeah.
And this man been doing this for 20 years, and he still haven't managed to leverage the cash that he got. And he bought land already, because there was literally a school bought in New York, real estate from that time. He could have just take the money from that school and literally get the land that he want, but he don't want land.
Right.
He just knows that y'all don't understand how life works. He could leverage the stuff he already owns to get the land. He don't want y'all to have no land. Yes. That's the joke.
Yes, the joke.
I don't get it. I don't get it.
That's right.
Yes. Yes.
But here's the thing. Now they being exposed. Because y'all could clearly see, you know, the hypocrisy, how they sitting up in there in them high seats, and they telling y'all, you know, hey, we blameless and all that other stuff, and then, you know, we showed y'all where all of the deacon Malachi, he was sleeping with that man's betrothed. We showed you how Yahweh Sip sitting up in there drunk trying to teach them.
Yes.
He ain't got the nerve to come back and teach a class like he ain't no drunk, right? Talking about you blameless if you were drunk. And he talking about himself. And you look and you see all of this stuff. The Captain REA sitting there laughing whenever Captain Shemaiah said the money with Jesus.
Money with Jesus. All
you know, no, it's just... It's a money game. The joke's on y'all.
Yes, yes. Because Jesus, his doctor showed up. I'm telling you straight up. Go to Matthew 10:8, because we're done with this one. We already read this. Matthew 10:8.
Yeah, I was about to get something up, but that's all right. Matthew 10:8.
Yeah. You want to go over there?
If I remember right, they already collected money for land before.
Yes.
And there was no land...
They bought that land.
It's a racket.
It's a racket.
Okay.
In Africa, remember that now.
Yeah, yes. It's a racket.
They had took all that money, and they said they was buying all kind of land. Now they got their own parcels for themselves that they used the money whenever they sent all that. They claimed they got over there in Africa. This was years ago. They claimed they got over there in Africa. Oh, we done ran out of money. If y'all could send money. Now, mind you, the economies in Africa ain't nowhere near what the economy here in America is, right? That mighty dollar go a long way in most of those areas over there in Africa. So what they did was they gave you the impression that they couldn't hardly eat over there. But they was taking the money that y'all sent them, and they was buying land. That's why the man was able to build that... He built a temple over there in Africa. It's only two places he got paid off. That one over there in Africa and the one up there in New York. All right? Ain't all of the rest of them churches he got, all of them, they rent. Some of them, they rent a room at the hotel every week.
And they
have class at the hotel.
Nothing but a racket.
All that money they done got from y'all. All of them men's conferences. We showed y'all, if it's 1,000 men, they'd have made at least $150,000 every time they have one of them men conferences.
Nothing but a racket. Nothing about
making off of the hotel rooms and all that other stuff. Y'all sitting here, y'all giving them all that money. If it's about to be over, what they need the money for?
Yeah.
Every century in each country, they have to, and they send money secretly to the New York.
Yes, yes. He got a bunch of franchises.
Every century, worldwide, they send money even to the New York.
Yeah, yeah. It's just like he own a chain of Zaxby's or something. He getting franchise fees from all them people.
Yeah,
but they ain't got no monthly. They don't have any building that they paying for. For them people over there, all that money they splitting that money. They getting enough money to pay the rent wherever it is that they doing the classes at, and then the rest of that money going in their pocket. The rest of it going in their pocket.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
But read that, Elder.
Matthew chapter 10 and verse 8. Heal the sick.
Heal the sick. Their doctrine's all messed up. Are they sick over there?
Yes.
Now they're trying to, buy up every brother. You repeat the same thing of the Esau did.
Yes.
You grabbing onto the heel. He said he wanted what? A spiritual house.
Yes. Yes.
He don't dwell in buildings. He want a spiritual house. Correct. He gonna throw it all back down. He gonna throw it all back down. Read.
Cleanse the lepers. In raise your mind, the dead.
Okay. The lepers are, in your mind, you think that you got a white doctrine. Your doctrine is pure in your mind.
Right.
You got a defiled doctrine in your mind. That's lepers. He's healing doctors right here. This is what Christ is doing.
Yeah.
Read. Raise the dead. Raise the dead from not walking dead. You're going to have the light, the spiritual interpretation.
Yeah.
That's what he's talking about. Raise the dead because you're in a graveyard. He called it those graveyards right now. That's what he called them. Those are the churches. Because you teaching, the pastor is teaching you carnally. He wants you to know his doctrine. He wants the meat. And we're going to touch on that today. He's serious about this meat. He about to reject all that stuff. All that stuff going to come to the light very soon. Read.
Cast out devils.
Stop. Those people in your, those people that's teaching you carnally, he call them deceivers.
Yes.
That's not, they're not teaching his doctrine.
Yes.
They are devils, what he call them. They are deceivers.
Yes.
Read.
Freely ye have received, freely give.
Freely.
Keep saying
freely.
Keep saying
why
free.
Why are you giving you his money? I mean, your money. Giving him your money. Why? It's silly. That is, and I want to address this. If you know somebody in your family, your personal biological family needs some help. All of us do. We know somebody. Help. If you know a person down the street needs some help, one of your neighbors, help. Your mama needs some help. Help. Your daddy needs some help. Help. Cousin, sister, brother, help them. Mama gonna always need some help. You can't run out of helping mama. Y'all are gonna need some help. Help somebody in the nursing home. If you got extra money, sponsor somebody in the nursing home. Stop giving it to them clowns. That's all they're doing is go. If you try to help someone, help somebody that way. If you got money to do that. But to help them build a church where God don't dwell, he want a spiritual house. He gonna tear it all back down.
Can I get a priest? You gonna tear it?
Yes, sir.
All right. Galatians, go to Galatians 4:26. You're talking about free, right? The doctrine. Because they're charging people for the doctrine, but the Most High keeps telling us all the time it's free.
It's free.
Read that, Elder.
But y'all don't make Elder Anderson mad now.
You done brought him out.
Y'all done made him mad now.
Y'all
he can't take it no
more.
He
gunned up over there.
Oh, man. Lord have mercy.
Read that, Elder.
Galatians chapter 4 and verse 26. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free. Which is the mother of us all.
That's right. The mother of us all is free. That doctrine free. That's a
free
doctrine. You can't charge for. Y'all understand that? Notice. Yeah. Now,
Christ already paid. He paid the price.
We done messed around and got a little popular around here with a couple of people watching us and all that other stuff. But we ain't charging a dime for this word. Not a dime.
You said something.
What you said?
I said Christ paid the price.
Yes.
So there's no fee. There's nothing to be paid. His blood, life was paid for us.
Yes.
So why the heck am I giving anybody money for this doctrine?
Right.
Yeah.
Why would you do that? Yeah, the guys that's watching this, you guys gotta wake up, man. You guys gotta understand. Everything that we're bringing out is showing you proof. We gave like what 5-7 precepts showing you that it's free.
Read.
Stop giving your money for the kingdom. You can't buy your way into heaven.
Oh, you praise can't. To the Most High. You said something. You said something right there, brother. Brother, you got to come to him. You got praise. To have a clean. All praise to the Most High. You got to come to him all like praise. A child. Say, Most High, I want to know this doctrine.
Yes.
Don't hate. The number key thing is don't hate nobody. Don't hate. He'll dang give it to you. Bro. You can't hate. I don't care what went on in the past. You can't hate. He will give it to you. Yeah.
People did. But look here. Look here. If now they're telling you, they need this land. They got to buy the land. You know, we need the land. So, you know, we'll have this land. But read that right there, El.
Yeah, I'm gonna. Yeah, damn. I'm gonna touch on that too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You
can Daniel answer. Chapter 7. Daniel chapter 7, verse 18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
I always hear Nathaniel bring this scripture right here. Mm-hmm. He's telling mm-hmm. we gonna take the kingdom. We gonna take the kingdom.
Why y'all buy land?
if he don't get the Most High, ain't that scripture say the one thing that we know the Most High can't do is lie, right?
Yeah, he
right.
can't lie. Yeah, he can't lie.
Now he's sitting here. He done made Daniel write this thing. Read that again, Elder.
But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom,
read,
and possess the kingdom forever. Even forever and ever.
That means the Most High, he gonna take the kingdom. If the Most High and all his power and infinity, you know, this is the according to the doctrine that Nathaniel and all these Israelite camps teach. If he's saying he gonna take the kingdom, right? Why, pray tell, must you go to PayPal? Why must you use that QR code to get this man this money? If the Most High gonna give it to you freely, as we've been reading, free, if he gonna give you the kingdom freely, why you got to pay this man to secure the kingdom for you?
And one of his minions, Barnabas, right, in the lies he tell, he gonna go on the thing and say it's a church in New York that got ATMs on every corner. Well, you ain't no different from no church in New York, because you got a QR code and everybody got an ATM right on their phone. So you got more ATMs than the church in New York.
They totally
just got them the money now because they got simple people following them. But the saints are the ones who killed the old person. Psalm 50.
See, they don't know that.
But I want to break this down, Elder. That Dan 7 and 18. Then I want to go to some. If you go to yours, if you want to first. But the saints are Daniel. Psalms 50 verse 5. The one that killed the old person. Romans 6 and 6. That's the old person. You have to be born again. 2 Corinthians 5 and 17. But and this one, the kingdom. It's a level of understanding.
That's what it is.
And I wanted to touch on it. And possess the kingdom forever and ever. That's not your property. The most everything belongs to the high. You're going to have that spirit. And that spirit going to pour out on the people next to you. A righteous spirit. That's what you're going to possess them with. So them devils in your house. Yes. Now, the kingdom. I want to break down this kingdom, Paul, Elder.
Mm-hmm.
Go to 2 Samuel 3 and 1. So you're going to possess the kingdom. This is how David, one of my mentors, our mentor.
Mm-hmm.
Read that right there.
2 Samuel chapter 3 and verse 1. Now there was long war between the house of Saul and the house of David.
Mm-hmm.
Elders of Israel. Read.
But David waxed stronger and stronger.
Elders of Israel.
And that
struggle with the Most High's doctrine.
Yes.
Read.
and the house of Saul waxed weaker and weaker.
IUIC don't have a doctrine. Give me your money.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Jump the team. This how we're gonna take the kingdom.
Yes.
Verse 10. To translate the kingdom.
Stop. From carnal to spiritual.
Yes.
Translate from carnal to spiritual.
From the house of Saul.
IUIC.
And to set up the throne of David over Israel and over Judah. From Dan even to
even Beersheba. The wicked, even the ones that were wicked.
Yes.
Even the stranger. Wasn't Beersheba a stranger? She came from a distance, from the ends of the earth.
Yes.
We're gonna possess it with this doctrine.
Yes.
Your king has returned.
Yes.
But y'all missed him. Y'all didn't even see him.
Yes.
And I grabbed on to that garment.
Yes, absolutely. I know that's right.
He said, Sam, turn me loose. I said, no, you can't go. You're going to have to bless me.
That's right. Bless me. This is almost a break a day.
Yes, sir.
About to get mine now. But
that's how the kingdom going to be took.
He ain't only saying it in Daniel. He's saying it right here, too. Read that. They always read it.
Yes, I thought about that too. Yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
Day before yesterday. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Obadiah chapter 1 and verse 21. And the Savior shall come up on Mount Zion.
What's Mount Zion?
Mount Zion is Israel.
Spiritual doctrine.
That's the spiritual doctrine. That's the spiritual congregation.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Let me add something to that too. You guys got to catch the words. Viewers, always look, come up, going up, just spiritual.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, elders.
Go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
And the Savior shall come up on Mount Zion to judge the Mount of Esau.
What's the judge?
And the kingdom.
What does judge mean? Judge means teach. That's a please.
Brother.
Ecclesiasticus 10 and 1.
I went to my phone today, and brother, the phone broke down something. I had no idea. This man, this man doing something on his computer, he changing the Bible, how to read the Bible differently now.
Mm-hmm.
I'm serious. Mm-hmm. I had no idea that computer broke down something. Mm-hmm. When I looked some up, he had it right there. Broke it down spiritually from carnal to spiritual.
Wow.
It used philosophical words, but I understood. I said, good God Almighty, they're getting it.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
They're getting it.
Yep. Read that out.
And the kingdom shall be the Lord's.
See there? He's saying they're going to take the kingdom. Just like he said in Daniel 7. He's saying the same thing here. That the saints gonna take the kingdom. He called them saviors, yeah.
Right? Saviors.
But at the end of the day, something gonna happen. Because people starting to see it now. So them lies that they've been telling, all them lies they got them people believing, we're gonna go over here to Isaiah.
Yes. So we're gonna break down some. Mm-hmm. In the law in a little while.
Mm-hmm.
He won't meet. He don't want none of that stuff no more. He don't want that garbage.
Right. Check out what they're
about. When you're done, can I provide a precept when you're done, Elder?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Isaiah chapter 17 and verse 13. The nation shall rush like the rushing of many waters.
There's going to be a whole lot of doctrines out there. Everybody going to be telling their doctrine, running their grill. Right?
But God shall rebuke them.
They getting rebuked now. Just like IUIC got rebuked with that Superman Jesus. The Most High made them people look like fools. He said he gonna laugh at your calamity. Are you not entertained? Because the Most High certainly entertained y'all whenever we went up in there and showed you how foolish them people look. Read that.
Yes.
And they shall flee far off.
Now they getting ready to start packing their bags, right? Mm-hmm. They trying to get that old big payback.
Right? Yes.
They about to roll up out of there, so they have to come up with something to get y'all to feel glad about giving to them. Mm-hmm. But it came mm-hmm. up with this thing where they need to buy this land. But the Most High said he going to give them the kingdom freely.
He going to give it to it freely.
So what they need this money for? He telling you what's happening, right?
Yes.
Read.
And shall be chased as the chaff of the mountain before the wind.
So the wind is that doctrine. They're going to be running from the doctrine. They're it running sure from this spiritual interpretation. He telling yes. you what's going on.
Yes.
He telling
yes.
you what's going down. All right. Y'all he, just need he, to pay know, attention. Right?
He Most High giving him dreams. Now this man is terrified. This man yes. know he got to get this money because he know he going to be on the run the rest of his life. He's Cain. He's the descendant of Cain. He's the descendant of Cain. Yes. But get out of the Bible, he's the descendant yes. of Cain. He got a Canaanite doctrine.
That's right. Read.
And like a rolling thing before the whirlwind.
They about to be getting up out of here like tumbleweeds in a second. I'm here to tell you. They got to convince y'all that they still righteous, but they need this money. They just need this money for this one more thing before everything come to an end. Right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But what they doing is they packing their suitcases, and whenever they yes. get that money, y'all gonna look up and they gonna be gone.
Hmm. Yes.
The scriptures, where's that scripture talk about the chase rope?
It's in Isaiah. It's yeah.
What is it, Isaiah 14? What is that chase rope?
But you quoted something similar to Habakkuk 2 and 4. You think they ain't gonna bite you back when old people find out
yes.
they've been flim flam.
Yes.
Yeah. Got hooked with a rusty hook. Brother, let me tell you something. And the thing is, the Most High is going to give them the understanding. It's going to be up to them to choose life or death. They're going to see the life part.
Yes.
Every one of his followers, they're going to see it. They're going to say, oh, man, I saw it. It's going to be up to them to walk Galatians 5 and 16 and 17, walk in his path. Mm-hmm. Yeah, walk his way.
Yes.
The highway. Yeah.
Read that.
Isaiah chapter 13, verse 14. And it shall be as a chase rope, and as a sheep that no man taketh up.
There ain't nobody going to take them up, like Elder Anderson was talking about, up. Ain't nobody going to teach what? Them. Ain't nobody going to want to have nothing to do with them. Right? They're going to understand that it's over. But they're mm-hmm. not going to be able to get the understanding of salvation. Because ain't nobody going to yes. want to have nothing to do with them. Because it done robbed the people.
It's in the scriptures. He said, King David had prayed about it. He said, I don't want them to find their path.
Right.
Yes.
Read that. You know.
They shall every man turn mm-hmm. to his own people.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And flee every one into his own land.
See that?
Mm-hmm.
They're not
mm-hmm.
going to be able to get the land of salvation. The land of salvation yes. is the spiritual doctrine.
Zechariah 2 and 6.
Ain't nobody going to take them in. Everybody going to realize. People going to say, look, I can only help my people. All right? They ain't going to want to have nothing to do with that kind of foolishness that they got out no, there that they're trying to sell on people. People going to reject that stuff. And all of them yes. men, they're going to have to stand for what they did. What you said you have, Elder Contessa?
Yes, it's for possess. Proverbs 8, verse 22.
So when you start talking about, they're talking about the possess and all that other stuff. They think they're talking about they're going to put them people in chains.
Mm-hmm. No, bro.
Right. No. That ain't what it's talking about. Y'all, all y'all calling people, because the man that opened up the vault now So y'all mm-hmm. sitting here thinking these people just gonna come up in here and just gonna allow you to put chains on them, and then y'all gonna whoop them son up, and all this other kind of stuff. And all that, the minute you go over there and start trying to impose your will on them people, they're gonna let you hold something. I'm just telling you, they're gonna let you hold something. Them people far from afraid of you. Trust And whenever the Most High don't come and rescue you from that that kind of beat down that you get from these people talking about you a Superman now, you know, you got a cape and you can climb the walls like Spider-Man. Ain't nobody gonna be able to help you at that point.
Nah.
Do that for me, Elder.
Proverbs chapter 8 verse 22. The Lord possessed me in the beginning of his way.
Doctrine.
Before his works of old.
It's doctrine. Oh, that's a good precept right there. Possessing means they possessing in your mind. Like Elder Samuel was saying. You're going to possess them people with your doctrine. Them people are going to realize it's over, and it's going to be the only doctrine of hope.
Yes.
That's the only doctrine of hope.
Yes.
Elder, you remember when you was bringing out that that Nathaniel can't repent because of he owed
a lot,
a return,
a lot,
owe a lot.
That's what Exodus 22.
So
I think it's Exodus 22.
It's another reason why he can't repent, neither though.
What's that?
Because I'm being facetious, but I'm being it's some truth in it. If he let's say he did say, you know what, I'm wrong. How is he gonna feed himself when y'all been paying his bills for the last 20 years?
Yeah. Well, he's gonna be like Saul. He's just like Saul because he see this doctrine. He seen it.
He see it.
Brother, we made personal doctrines for them brothers because we love them. Mm-hmm. We don't want nothing to happen to them, but we're gonna get out the scripture because our word ain't nothing. I mean, the word ain't nothing. God has taken us so far, we even know what's gonna happen in the afterlife in this Bible. Yes. To the person who cursed the Holy Ghost. This brother, you're not forgiven. What sin he don't forgive you of?
Blasphemy.
Y'all can call Samuel black, naphead, grayhead, shouted this and that and this and that. Y'all can do that to me, but if you do something against this Holy Ghost, blaspheme the Holy Ghost.
Yeah,
this what we teach you right here.
Yes.
You casting away Christ.
Yes.
This is the cornerstone for salvation. 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 The spiritual house.
Yes.
And he know it. They know it.
Yeah.
But his pride, they so impressing to have men worship them.
Yeah.
But then them to teach to worship God. Y'all notice that?
Yeah.
That's all about land. What about salvation? They don't forgot about that. That's what the Mark 4 is about. He's going to take you off from what you was created to do, and now he taking you back into the world. And this man about to blow up the earth pretty soon.
Yeah. It ain't going to...
It's going to get worse. It's going to get worse. It's going to... Most High is going to get his flock back.
Yes.
By any means necessary.
Yes.
He's going to get them back. He's going to take it. He's going to take them.